As a doctor, you're confronted with all of these deep mysteries. Why do some people get cancer and others don't? With COVID, why do some people get a runny nose and other people end up in the ICU? I would just agonize about these questions all the time. I started to see that a lot of those questions that I was struggling with as a doctor were really great questions for algorithms. Ken Griffin's philanthropic team was interested in taking the data-driven mentality that's fueled a lot of other advances in finance and consumer behavior and applying that to making discoveries in medicine. And I think that holds the key to new insights into the underlying biology of illness, how to diagnose it, and more importantly, how to treat it.
This is Ziad Obermeyer, physician, professor, philosopher, and artificial intelligence researcher. He's the founder of Nightingale Open Science, an open source data hub that seeks to enable the use of machine learning for groundbreaking medical research.
Nightingale Open Science is a computing platform that houses massive medical data sets. We start with an interesting medical question, for example, sudden cardiac death. It's a really urgent problem. And the way we handle it is we get data sets of electrocardiograms and we link those to a handful of outcomes. And then we put those data on our platform where any researcher anywhere in the world can access them for free. Humans are good at focusing in on one or two things, but something like an X-ray or an electrocardiogram, there's an enormous amount of data that no human mind can process. There's a lot of promise in applying those machine learning techniques that have extracted such rich signal in other fields, whether it's trying to predict what you're going to enjoy on Netflix to looking at these very complex traffic patterns and routing you on the best route. A lot of those algorithms can be applied to those rich medical data that we have stored in healthcare systems.
Nightingale Open Science is partnering with hospitals to help them put their data to use, which enables doctors to access invaluable insights for patients while contributing to Nightingale's growing data set for researchers around the world. One of Nightingale's partners is Carlo Bifulco, a leading researcher working in the burgeoning field of digital pathology at Providence.
Carlo was sitting on these decades worth of analog slides from biopsies that had been done. A doctor had looked at it, and then that slide got put on a shelf where it was literally collecting dust for years. With philanthropic support from Ken Griffin, we were able to work with them to buy slide scanners and hire technicians so that we could de-identify it and put that data set on Nightingale while keeping patient data safe.
Historically, there has been a lot of focus on features of the tumor itself, but not the surrounding cells.
By understanding this picture, we may actually be able to predict outcomes in our patient population in a way that is currently not possible through conventional morphology. AI and machine learning and the Project Nightingale may really open the doors to that kind of opportunity in the future.
The way innovation works, you need lots of people with great ideas. And right now, there are a lot of people who want to be contributing to this field, but can't because they can't touch the data. I think over the coming years, as we add more and more data sets, I think this is going to be the place where researchers come to do their work on medical imaging data sets and solve the most interesting problems in medicine.